In this next problem, we have sort of an artificial situation to help understand the equilibrium conditions. So we have two solids. The left side, we have ethanol solid and ethanol liquid. The right side, we have ice, frozen water, and water liquid. And then this divider here is insulated. So the vapor phase, then when we start, right, this is open. So the vapor phase is going to contain both water vapor and ethanol vapor. We assume no energy transfer. Q is zero for the system. And no transfer between the sides. And the question is, what happens? And we might say, what happens initially? And essentially, what we're looking at here is, how do we get to equilibrium? What's the driving forces? What happens to fugacities? So if we look here, we have ethanol plus water in the vapor phase, and only water in the liquid phase, then the fugacity of ethanol is higher here than here. And so on the right side, ethanol must condense. The reason being, we're trying to get to equilibrium, which means fugacity of ethanol in the vapor must equal fugacity of ethanol in the liquid. And so if ethanol is condensing, that would create a driving force for ethanol to move this way, and that would cause more ethanol to vaporize to again establish equilibrium. By the same reasoning, on this side, we have water and ethanol in the vapor phase, so on the left side, water will condense. Again, trying to get to equilibrium where the fugacity of water in the liquid phase and the fugacity of water in the vapor phase are the same. Initially, water fugacity is higher in the vapor phase. So then the question is, what are the consequences of diluting the water on the right side with ethanol, diluting the ethanol on the left side, start out with just ethanol in the liquid phase, by water? So we're lowering the fugacity of water on the right side. And so now on the right side, ice will melt because its fugacity is higher than the fugacity of water in the liquid phase because we diluted the water, lowered the fugacity of water in the liquid phase. So ice will melt, and on the left side, ethanol will melt. And then the final question is, what are the consequences of the melting? Well, if ice melts, and this is an adiabatic system, the energy must come from somewhere, so the energy comes from lowering the temperature. And likewise, on the left side, lowering the temperature. And this is strictly energy balance. We have some heat of melting. The energy we have to put in the ice to melt it must come from the surrounding materials, the liquid, so the temperature of everything decreases. And this is an artificial system, but it gives a good indication of this idea of fugacity. And when we're at equilibrium, fugacity must be the same, the different phases for each component. So we're trying to get to equilibrium. The ice is going to continue to melt. Ethanol is going to continue to melt because we like the fugacity of water in the liquid phase be equal to fugacity of water in the solid phase, equal to fugacity of water in the vapor phase. And all we're looking at is the initial behavior in this system.